guests today could teach a course in how to rock the world as a boy band. They were the authors of the very first cassette tape that I ever bought and ever listened to. They are back with their first album in 15 years. Give it up for New Kids on the Block.
Cool
for us too.
You know what? You can stand wherever you want.
Should I? They didn't.
You're fine. All right, now you guys sold over 70 million albums. As wow. I mentioned, one of those was bought by me.
Went down.
We'll take that.
And we have eagerly awaited your return for 15 years. All right, so good to have you guys back together. I want to know what was the number one thing that you guys missed while you were apart?
TRL.
Because this show's not even on the air 10 years.
Yeah, so. The show, see, this is what's so different. Everything is different now. There's downloading. When we perform, we use in-ear monitors. There's TRL. There's so many things that didn't even exist. So I think we miss a lot of the old school stuff probably and are ready to, like our tour buses didn't have satellite and internet now, but now they do.
That's pretty cool.
In fact, they didn't even have internet when we last were out recording. Yeah. Sorry,
we're not that old.
No, we're not that old.
Come on.
We're not that old.
You're kidding. No, they had internet. No.
All right, Donnie, it's been reported that actually you guys reunited because of a demo that you received. What's the story there?
Well, I was actually in New York City. I'm getting ready to work on a film, Right to Skill, which comes out September 12th. And for some reason, I just happened by our music attorney's office, and he just handed me a sealed envelope. He said there's a demo of some kid in there. Give it a listen. And I went home and listened to it in Boston, and I fell in love with it. And I was not far from Jordan, so I went by to get his opinion. And Jordan was like, I love it, too. And I sent it to Joe, and he loved it, and John and Danny loved it. So it just seemed like the perfect record for us to do if we were ever going to do a record again. And we all agree that if we ever got back together, we'd want it to be about the music first, not about, you know, nostalgia and trying to go out and make all the money and make it about the wrong reasons. We want to do an album and let the music speak for us. Because the music didn't always speak for us in the past, and we really wanted it to do it right if we were going to do it again.
Fantastic. Well, we are just getting started with New Kids on the Block. After we take our first break, we're going to take a look at their brand new video. It actually features Neo. Yes, you heard correctly. Keep it right here, guys. TRL is only getting better. It's premiered in what year? The answer, 1984, just 3 years after MTV launched. Bring it back. We want to see it. We're going to talk about it right now. I'm hanging out with New Kids on the Block.
The Block.
During the break, they hooked up. This city right here, it's called The Block, and we're going to have a chat about it right now. So feel free just to jump in, guys. So it's in stores now.
Yes.
And I want to know, what is it like putting out a new album after like a decade and a half? Are you guys nervous, excited, bit of both?
They're in littler packages these days. It used to be big vinyl round. And
it's exciting. We're very proud of this record. I mean, we have some amazing collaborations. Our new single with Neo. We have a duet with Pussycat Dolls. We have a duet with Akon. We have a duet with New Edition, which is like a lifelong dream of ours. We grew up in the same city as them and grew up sort of worshiping and idolizing them, and they really paved the way for us. So to do a song with them is amazing. I mean, we work with Polo the Don, Timbaland, Red One. I mean, so many producers. It's really an album that we're very proud of.
And yeah, we just mentioned that you collaborate with Akon, and the song's called Put It On My Tab. Hot. So have you guys got a bit hip-hop? Is there going to be rapping on this album?
Wait, there was always rapping on all of our albums.
Step one.
No, not even that. Not even that. Even though that was kind of rap. Yeah, a little bit.
It wasn't always good rapping, but it was rapping.
I loved that song. All right, so you're going into a little bit more hip-hop.
We got a little bit of everything. I mean, you know, it's definitely, it's kind of like urban pop, you know? It's urban-based and music we love to listen to. But when we get on a record and we sing, it definitely has that classic New Kids sound. But we think we bridged the gap pretty well. We're excited about it.
Well, yeah, I mean, you've worked with Neo. I mean, what was that like? I mean, he's known for his hits. So, I mean, did you know right away that this was going to be a big song for you?
The song just grabbed us immediately. And Neo's an amazing talent. He's very professional. And he's very old school. You know, his work ethic, his dedication to his craft, and the touch that he puts on. He's very, very old school. And we really appreciate the work ethic of for a younger guy to have that level of work ethic. You know, it really inspires us because that's the school that we come from. You know, hard work.
Yeah. All right. Well, we're going to check it out right now. Here they are, New Kids on the Block with Neo. This is Single.
It's gonna sound and look as good as it sounded you saying bigger and better.
Aww.
It sounded amazing. So it's gonna be great. People are gonna be surprised. I think we're not bringing out stools and sitting down and singing our old hits. I mean, we're really, I think we're dancing more now than we were back in the day. So and we're mixing it in. We got all the old hits, but we got new music that we're excited to share. So it's gonna be hot.
Do you know who's gonna open for you guys yet?
Right now we have a couple. We have Natasha Bedingfield is going to be doing a lot of dates.
She's a great girl.
As well as two new artists, Lady Gaga, who we love.
Yep.
We actually have a duet with her on the album as well, and she co-wrote another song with us. And Tammy Chin, who is an up-and-coming artist who's on Akon and Red One's label. And Colby O'Donnell's going to do a few dates. So, I mean, it's just going to be a hot, hot show. It's going to be very exciting, and, man, we can't wait. If you ain't seen us before, you better see us now, because we know how to do it.
All right.
We know how to do it.
Guys, it was fantastic to meet you. Thank you so much for coming on our show today. And we'll see you on the tour, I guess. We will play more videos from this year's VMA performers, and when we return, the lovely Hayden Panettiere will join us. Our hit series, Heroes, is back, and we're going to hear all about it, so make sure you don't move.